On the banks of the Tennessee River, we're in Knoxville, Tennessee at Neyland Stadium.
And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Tennessee has lined up for the kickoff, and we're ready to get this one underway. He really got a hold of that kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Throws into coverage, just picked off. Got an opening. And they make the stop at the 2-yard line. And the quarterback just can't believe it. He really wishes he could have that one back.
Every quarterback has passes that he wishes he could have back. However, hey, a pick is a pick, and no one is going to care how bad he wants that one back.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. First and goal from the 2, and they can smell the end zone.
Scrambling around. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown.
Well, this quarterback has great instincts, but he showed his smarts here as well, seeing that there was room to run for the touchdown instead of trying to force the pass.
And he adds the extra point.
He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 26-yard line.
Tennessee's really got things working right now for him. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
Their last drive ended with an interception. We're about to find out what the defense can do this time.
It may be early, but don't think the coaches haven't spent a lot of time reminding these guys how important it is to take care of the football.
From their own 30-yard line, it's second down. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. The pitch, and he's got some room.
At the 30, to the 20.
Tackle made around the 12-yard line.
Some guys are dangerous no matter where they are on the field. Whether they have speed, elusiveness, great vision, whatever the case may be, you have to find ways to get the ball in their hands.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. Empty backfield. Quarterback in the gun. 5 wide receivers.
And he's taken down at the 1-yard line.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
They've got their goal line sets on the field. This might be a good time for play action.
They'll bring him down at the 1.
From the 1-yard line, second down.
Touchdown, Bulldogs. The halfback just plowed his way into the end zone.
Yeah, but it wasn't all him. The offensive lineman just pancaked the defense on that one.
We'll be tied with the extra point. And he tacks on the extra point.
A nice 5-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. It can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
We get a tie game at 7-7. And so far, it's been totally even. In close games like this, every possession is likely to matter. Brought down at the 28-yard line. Their own 28-yard line. It's second down. Throws and it's incomplete. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
He's scrambling, and he can't get away from the pressure.
He has one job on passing situations: get to the quarterback, and he did that job very, very well on that play.
Brooks is waiting for the snap. And he's taken down at the 48-yard line.
I think this defense right now needs somebody to try to lift up their spirits. They seem to really be just out there kind of going through the motions. And I think the last time they were out there where they gave up such a long drive has had an impact and an effect negatively on the psyche of this defense.
It's second down, 8 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. They hit him in the backfield. White gets the ball. Brought down after a nice run up the middle. And he didn't get enough for the first.
Now, Brad, he's going to come up short here. The defense does a nice job of not allowing the ball carrier to get out into the open.
Big kick here to try to pin the offense deep in their own territory. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is a fun game, and I think we're going to see a lot of interesting football before it's over. The halfback tackle around the 19-yard line.
You don't want that. You don't want that. You don't want that.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on the 19.
Mike 7.
Man, that's what I do.
Oklahoma.
Got it. And he goes down quickly. Fourth down.
Nice defense. That was picture perfect. Three and out. Good series for these guys.
The punting team's got to give their kickers some time. Nice yardage on the run back. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. He lets it go. Incomplete, almost picked off.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? He drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Quick toss. Tipped away.
And he did a nice job breaking up that pass.
Well, he did a great job here of not risking a big gain. Instead, he just batted it down.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 46. Going deep, lays it out there, tipped away. That safety got in the way on that one.
He made a great play on the ball, and he kept it from being a big gain. Excellent awareness to get a hand on the football.
He really got a hold of that one. Tackle made at the 17. So he got a little on that return.
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the seam closed quickly.
They've got to play with some focus and smarts here. They don't want to make a mistake and suddenly find themselves trailing.
Steps out of bounds around the 21-yard line. From their own 21-yard line, second down. Fires that quickly, incomplete. Defense goes with the extra defensive back as the offense comes up five wide. He's wrapped up for the sack. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. Jackson takes it at the 43. He gets out to about the 42-yard line.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
And it's caught. He's tackled around the 29-yard line.
Let's go, D. Let's go, D.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. Here's a run. Good outside run there. So they get 5 yards there on the halfback draw. To the back, and he's level at the 15. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 15.
10's the mic. 10's the mic.
So at the end of one, we're even at 7 in this one. And we welcome you back to the action here, and we have got a tight one going on in quarter number two. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. And down he goes around the 5-yard line.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Nice run there. White gets about 4 yards on the play.
Andy's getting the ball here. Andy's getting the ball. Come on. You better bring it.
Ready, huh? Up there, up.
Touchdown, Georgia.
There are some guys, when they get near the goal line, they just have a knack for getting the ball into the end zone. That's what we saw right there.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Georgia ready to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
He passes it. Incomplete pass.
You know, Brad, this is one of those plays where the quarterback just wants to apologize to the wide receiver and maybe every other member of this offense. But the wide receiver, if he's smart, will come up to that quarterback, tell him to forget about it. Let's move on to the next play.
Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Quick throw, incomplete, wanted his receiver. Brooks awaits the snap. He's taken down at the 43-yard line.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Georgia is up a score. Run play, and he'll lose yards.
But you can really mess with an offense's game plan if you can take away their ability to run.
From their own 41-yard line, second down.
And he's tackled right around the 46-yard line. Wants it all, going deep. Can't connect. They're really fortunate that wasn't intercepted.
Not a very smart decision by the quarterback. He had no shot at completing it.
Second and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Gross falling back and got his man. He's taken down
around the 40-yard line.
Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. And they make the stop at the 31-yard line.
That is money in the bank. Sometimes you just can't stop a good combination.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 31.
Open man, quick strike, and he can't pull it in. Quick out to the receiver, and he can't make the grab. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Georgia is up by a touchdown.
They go with a run. They'll get him for a loss. And that play was snuffed out from the get-go.
You're right. It's a delayed handoff to the tailback, and the defense wasn't fooled at all there.
They call on the kicker for a long field goal. Georgia can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. It has the distance, and he nails the long field goal.
Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick.
He's to the 20. Brought down at the 26-yard line.
Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up.
Roger, Roger. Mike 17. Mike 17.
Fires out to his receiver, and he's taken down around the 30-yard line.
from their own 30-yard line. It's second down. He's going to try and scramble, and they get the sack.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. They found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26-yard line.
17's Mike. Mike 17.
Down. Blue 14.
They'll bring him down at the 39. Quick to an open man, he dropped it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 39.
Not today. Seven's a Mike. Mike seven. Yes.
And it's almost picked off.
Great reaction to get his hands in the way of that pass. That's not an easy play to make.
He can't hang. He's not gonna
five wide.
Mike 17, Mike 17,
set, tackle.
Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. It's away, and it's a booming punt. Jackson takes it to 15. He makes it out to maybe the 39-yard line. Georgia's been playing like a well-oiled machine in this first half. And Kirk, are we going to see more of the same in the second?
Well, I think as long as they can maintain the proper frame of mind, I think they've got a great shot to be able to pull away and win this game decisively. But the challenge for them will be listening to their coaches at halftime and continuing to play with that same aggressive attitude that they played with in the first half.
Tackle made around the 48-yard line. From the 48-yard line. First down.
Four down. Tim's the mic.
Let's go!
Quick throw to the back. It's incomplete.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, D. Mike team.
Open receiver dropped. It's third and 10. Ball on the 48.
Mike 10.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Doesn't want to let the punt returner have a chance here. He just wants to change field position. Kick. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. Their last drive ended in a punt, so this quarterback's going to be looking for something better on this drive. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. On the catch. Oh, they strip it out. From their own 20-yard line. Second down. Right, running back's got it. Brought down right around the 30. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Well, this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
Trying to
set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. He's at midfield. Good open field tackle.
You know, the great thing about a screen pass is, once it's executed, is to watch the linemen get downfield and have a chance to show their athletic ability in the open field. These guys are close to 300 pounds, some cases over 300 pounds, and here they are in the open field trying to block a guy that weighs 180 pounds or 190 pounds. And when it hits a big one, there's nothing better than watching those linemen be able to make a big play 10 or 15 or 20 yards downfield trying to open it up.
And a quick throw. And they push him out around the 26-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
From the 26-yard line, first down. They come out in a five-wide set. Throws incomplete, intended for his wide outs.
Roger, Roger. 17's Mike. Mike 17.
Hyatt. Blue 19.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Here's the eighth play of the series.
They're going to come up short here on third down to be able to pick up this first down, but at least they're in field goal range, and a smart coach will always take 3 points when he gets an opportunity.
So the kicker comes out. He'll try to put 3 points on the board, and they can make this a one-possession game with this kick right here. The kick is away. It's long enough, and he got it. Ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Tackle at the 25-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Georgia up 7 points. He's tackled at about the 23-yard line. So at the end of the half, the Bulldogs lead 17-10.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes.
We've been looking forward to this game all week and it has lived up to billing. A close game. You feel like that it's going to be a great second half, and boy, we've got the perfect guys in the booth. What a reward today for Nessler and Herb Street to get this game.
Well, you know, it's not a secret, Reese. They get the best game every week that we think's on the schedule, right? So they got this game. It's great. It's close. It's going back and forth. I mean, what a treat to watch one of the best games of the year just unfolding in front of us. And more importantly, to hear the silky smooth sounds of Kirk Herbstreit and Brad Nessler. Does it get any better?
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese, David, thanks, guys. Just about set to start the third quarter.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
And they bring him down for a sack on the play.
From their own 24-yard line, second down.
You're all mine, baby. You're all mine.
Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
Reset, tight right.
Mike 17, Mike 17.
Hey, check, check.
Set,
cut.
Passes to the back, incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Brooks to punt. Jackson
fields it at the 34.
Tackle made at the 46-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Georgia is up 7. Tackle at the 42-yard line. From the 42-yard line, it's first down. Takes a handoff, tackled for a loss. Zips it to the back, and he's hit immediately. Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. They spread the field in the gun with 5 wide receivers.
Here we go.
Going long. And he's got his receiver. It's the sophomore. Touchdown, Georgia. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
He makes the PAT. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball.
Down 2 possessions, this offense has to step up and capitalize on this possession.
He's out of bounds at the 30-yard line. From their own 30-yard line, second down. And down he goes, around the 42-yard line.
Roger, roger. Mike 7.
Here we go, T.
Set. Blue 14.
They'll wrestle him down in the backfield. From their own 42-yard line. It's second down. So the stop there on third and long, and that's going to bring up a punting situation.
The offense really had nowhere to go on that one. The play was very well defended, and now the incompletion will force the fourth down and a punt.
Brooks awaits the snap. He's out to to the 30. Gets to about the 34-yard line.
The Bulldogs have shown here in the third quarter they're not content to just sit on that lead they built in the first half.
Well, they did a nice job in the first half, but the adjustments that they made at halftime have allowed them to find some matchups to their advantage, and they've taken full advantage of that.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Well, you can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down.
From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. Fires quick, he catches another. And they make the stop around the 47-yard line. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's taken down right around the 44-yard line. So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. And he's tackled at the 44-yard line. He's at the 30, gains his way to the 23-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 23. They'll line up with five wide receivers. That's a great tackle at the 24. The catch and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. They come out in an empty backfield. Dumps it complete, the tight end over the middle. And he's taken down at the 20. Kicks up, and it splits the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Georgia's continuing to play extremely tough defense. This has been impressive.
It's just been impressive to watch them play with such an attitude, almost a chip on their shoulder with the energy that they're playing with. And I think it's going to require that kind of effort to be able to win this game.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game.
Gains his way to the 36-yard line.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 36. They'll bring him down at the 37.
You see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
Third down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36-yard line.
Down! Oklahoma! Cut!
Swings it out there, incomplete.
You know, I think the quarterback got so excited to make this throw that I think he just put too much on the football. His receiver was open. He just misfired.
Jackson is the deep man awaiting the return. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Well, the guys are chomping at the bit down there, waiting for the game to start back up. Throws a bullet over the middle. Tackle made at the 46. That's three down and one to go. Georgia's lead is 17. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Quarterback, don't get nervous now. We ain't begin to tear you up. Don't get nervous.
Here we go. Green 19. Green. Green.
Nice run there. 5 yards there for the quarterback.
Nowhere, baby. Nowhere. Let's go. Way to go, deep. Way to go, deep.
Second and five. Ball on the 49-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. See if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He steps out at the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, first down. He scrambles. There's a very impressive open field tackle. Well, they didn't get the first down, but it was still a pretty good run by the quarterback.
He made a good decision to take off there.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Four down. Mike 17. Set.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down at the 48-yard line. He's gobbled up in the backfield. From midfield. Second down.
Roger.
They come out in a five wide set.
Mike 17.
Set.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Incomplete.
You know, he's been working really hard lately on his fundamentals. In fact, the other day in practice, I was really watching him work with the quarterback coach, and they've been focusing on that aspect of it. Here, it looked like he may have taken a step backwards and really just let that one go.
He unloads it. And it's going the other way. It's the senior corner. He didn't throw it away under pressure, and it really cost him.
It sure did. He saw that he was going to get hit and just threw one up for grabs. He's got to learn to take the sack.
from their own 34-yard line. First down. And they get nice yardage on that run. He guns it to the right. And he snags that one. To the 20. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Nicely designed play to the wide receiver, and it got him six.
You said it, Brad, and a good time to call it. I tip my hat to the offensive coordinator.
Boy, that was an easy throw for the quarterback. Had to be a mistake of some kind or miscommunication by the defense in that secondary, but the quarterback finds his receiver wide open for the touchdown.
And he adds the extra point. Georgia is lining up to kick this one off. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
The Bulldogs have really been all over the place. They're playing like a defense possessed.
I love to watch a defense just pin its ears back and just fly to the football. They are playing with a reckless attitude, and it's really paid off because it set up their offense to be able to score points.
I'm sure the quarterback would love to make amends for that last pick.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Let's pick it up, Sam.
Quick throw. And they push him out at the 47-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 47-yard line.
There are five wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun.
Gets it out quickly. He's tackled at the 43. They'll spread the field with five wide. Fires out to his receiver, and he's shoved out of bounds right around the 30. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 30-yard line.
Just under three to go in regulation.
Tackle at the 22-yard line. Complete one of his receiver. So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Got a man in and out of his hands.
Tighten up. Pull together.
There's a strike complete, and he is drilled at the 18-yard line. First and 10, all on the 18-yard line. Inside handoff. He gets out to about the 15-yard line. This is the 10th play of the drive.
Seven,
slings it. And he hits him hard at the 10-yard line. Here comes the pressure. Goes to the receiver. Incomplete. The defense got some pressure and forced a bad pass.
I think they've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
And again, they're going for it on fourth down. Just over a minute left.
So the play of the day, fourth and ball game, and the defense comes up with the stop of the day and what will be the win.
This offense did really well with the air attack on their last trip out there. Let's see if they can do the same thing here.
So much of the passing game is about timing between the quarterback and his wide receivers. Right now with this offense, they are in sync, and really the timing and execution is flawless.
They line up at the 12. Second down. And down he goes at about the 25-yard line. And this one's all but wrapped up with the final score, 34-10, Bulldogs. So that wraps things up for us, for EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.